Almost all electric scooters till now came with removable batteries. But Ather started to make electric scooters with fixed batteries, and now Ola and a few other Indian manufacturers are following this crazy trend. Ola's case is very surprising because the Etergo scooter, which became the Ola scooter, was designed with a removable battery. But now it seems that Ola too will come with a fixed battery. The manufacturers give a lot of excuses why the scooter needs to have a fixed battery. But the real motive is to make money from their customers. These fixed battery scooter makers are also very energetic about creating charging infrastructure every 3 km. Charging infrastructure every 3 km. Charging infrastructure every 3 km. Removable battery has a lot of advantages over fixed battery, and the buyer should be aware about the problems of fixed battery. But before we do that, make sure you like the video, subscribe the channel and press the bell icon. Here are some of the problems that you can have with the fixed battery scooter. Number 1. When you are stranded with zero charge. Suppose you run out of charge and the nearest charging point is nearly 3 kilometers away. What would you do? Please note that the distance could be much more than that, but we'll take the best case scenario. What would you do? With a fixed battery scooter, you will have to push it for 3 kilometers or have it carried on a tow truck and pray that none of your friends see the sight. But with a removable battery scooter, you can park the vehicle, remove the battery, take a rickshaw or taxi home, charge the battery completely and go back to the vehicle. Limited mobility. With fixed battery, your range is limited to the availability of known charging stations in your area. If you are not sure if the place will have charging point within cable reach of the scooter, you will not travel to that area. If you are visiting your friends or relatives' house, and even if they live on the ground floor, it will not be good if the nearest power socket is beyond the reach of the charging cable. Therefore, with a fixed battery scooter, your travel will be limited to familiar areas. Having an app that shows you the nearest charging point is good, but not a solution, because this is because by the time you reach there, it could get occupied or it could be out of service. The situation will be just like the ATMs around us, meaning there could be a charging station near you, but it might not be working on that day. With removable battery, you can charge it very conveniently from hotel room, house, shops, restaurants, or even generators. With removable battery, you can always charge from charging points, but you also have the option and flexibility to charge it at other places. Number 3. Technical problem. If there is a battery problem, the whole fixed battery scooter has to be sent in for repairs. It could take weeks to troubleshoot, repair and get it back. If there is a fight, argument or misunderstanding between the dealer and the EV maker, or an inventory delay, it could even take months. Those days you will be without a scooter. With removable battery, you can just take the battery for repairs and use a scooter with the same battery from second vehicle in your house, or use a battery you bought. Or the dealer might provide you with a temporary old battery till the repairs are done. With removable battery, it is easy for you or the dealer to know the problem is with the battery by testing the vehicle with another battery. With a fixed battery scooter, the dealer can replace the battery with old one, but because of the time it will take, he will not go through the trouble to open the hatch, disconnect the wire, take out the battery and give you back the scooter. He will prefer that the whole scooter be with him till the problem is fixed. Number 4. Open market, battery replacement possible and more economical. When there is a problem with the removable battery, you can make or get a new battery pack made from battery companies in the open market. This can be easily done by carrying the battery to multiple vendors until you find the right price and quality. This is a little difficult with fixed battery unless you have the confidence to open the hatch, disconnect the wires of the fixed battery and carry it to the vendors. If you buy a replacement battery, it will always be cheaper to buy from the open market than from the vehicle maker. Number 5. Pay commercial electricity rates. With fixed battery, you will have to pay commercial electricity rates for charging from paid charging stations. Please note that commercial three-phase electricity will be required for fast charging and add to the service charge and then also add GST. So in effect, slow charge will be at least 3 times expensive and fast charging will be at least 5 times more expensive. Therefore, if you slow charge from a house, it will be just ₹10. From charging station, it will be approximately ₹30. But due to various factors, companies will over a period of time completely eliminate slow charging. We will discuss this in a while. So most of the time you charge from a charging station, it will cost you at least ₹50 for something that should have cost you ₹10. Thus, people with fixed battery scooters when away from home will have no option but to pay higher charges to charge from the charging network. While removable battery scooters can charge from houses of friends, relatives, strangers or hotels for free or for as little as ₹10. Number 6. Commercial charging rates will increase. Right now, commercial charging points are offering free or low rates to encourage people to use it. These rates will increase in the future and keep increasing just like the petrol rates are increasing today. Both government and charging companies are lying low for the moment and waiting for the fish to bite. Ather is also constantly extending its free charging deadline. They will pull the bait once the fish starts to bite. It wouldn't be surprising if these charging points cost you rupees 100 or 200 per scooter in a couple of years from now. There is also a possibility that these vehicle makers can prevent you from charging from home with a simple software update. By buying a fixed battery scooter, you are giving away the power from you to the EV maker. Number 7. Slow charging will die fast. Most commercial charging points will slowly do away with the slow charging because it will give them less profits. It will give them less profit for charging and less profit for battery sales. This is because if a fast charger can charge a scooter in 1 hour, it can charge 8 scooters in 8 hours. By charging rupees 50 for one scooter, for 8 scooters it can earn rupees 400 per point per shift. Now if that point was allotted to a slow charge scooter for 4 to 8 hours, it will get just rupees 30 from that one scooter. So this means that instead of 400, he will be getting just rupees 30 from that one charging bay. So if we consider a loss of rupees 300 per 8 hours in 3 shifts, this will be 900 per charging bay per day. If there were 10 charging bays and all of them slow charge for 24 hours, the loss in revenue will be 9,000 every day. Because of this, no commercial charging company will want to provide slow charging, which will be a big loss to them. There is no doubt that in the future, charging stations will completely eliminate slow charging. This is because of economics and to get more profit. Nobody is in the charging business because of charity or social cause. Thus, most people will have no option but to use fast charging when charging away from home and end up reducing their battery life even if they wish to charge overnight on a slow charging network. Will have no option but use fast charging and end up reducing the battery life. This will create a huge demand for batteries, the kind of which should have never occurred. The quicker the battery life is over, the EV maker will be able to sell more batteries and make more profit. Number 8. Dependence on charging stations. People will become dependent upon charging companies just like they were dependent upon petrol pumps. So people will move from a Reliance petrol pump today to Reliance charging station tomorrow. From an Indian Oil petrol pump today to Indian Oil charging station tomorrow. If we are going to do this, what kind of progress have we made? You will hear a lot of chatter online about India does not have EV infrastructure from these companies so that they can get cheap loans and cheap land from government to set up an infrastructure where none is required in the first place. With removable battery scooter, we can double our range with an extra battery, meaning a 120 km Okinawa scooter or a Revolt RV400 can travel 240 km with an extra battery or travel 360 km with two extra batteries. This is huge. This cannot be done with a fixed battery scooter. Well, this is not an everyday scenario that you are going to ride 240 km,
but still it is an option you have.
Number 10. ATHER'S scooter and ATHER'S grid is incompatible with industry standard CCS fast chargers. ATHER has cunningly designed its fast charging connector in a different manner so that its customers will not be able to fast charge from any other charging station other than ATHER's. Thus, ATHER customers will not be able to fast charge their scooters on government or third party fast charging networks. Similarly, other scooter owners will not be able to fast charge from ATHER grid. If this trend continues, it will impact the e-scooter market negatively and in the end, the loser will be the customer. However, electric car makers like E2O, Tata Nexon and Hyundai Kona have compatible CCS charging ports,
which are the industry standard if you consider the whole of Europe and the whole of India.
Automobile manufacturers that support CCS include BMW, Daimler, FCA, Ford, Jaguar, General Motors, Group E, PSA, Honda, Hyundai, Kia, Mazda, MG, Polestar, Renault, Tesla, Tata Motors and Volkswagen Group. Number 11. Fixed batteries are removable. Fixed batteries are removable, but not for customers. Technically, if you see fixed batteries, it is also a removable battery for the benefit of the EV maker, meaning they can access it and remove it when it goes in for repairs and then put it back. But they will not want you to have the benefits of taking it home to recharge. This again is to control your charging habits. It's a completely different matter with the toy electric scooters, which can be carried home for charging. So the vehicles which cannot be taken home need to have the option of a removable battery. Range proof. People argue fixed batteries gives better performance, have lighter weight and handling, and all of this will give higher range. This is not true. Fixed battery scooters like ATHER and CHETAK give almost identical range like most removable battery scooters. On the other hand, vehicles with removable battery like Revolt and Okinawa have given much better range than both ATHER or CHETAK, and that too at a better price point. People will buy more removable battery scooters than fixed battery scooters. So those who want to keep making fixed battery scooters will only get a small market. EV companies love fixed batteries because people will become completely dependent on them
for everything from repairs to fast charging so that they can exploit the customers. The biggest reason of all is consumer needs options and flexibility, irrespective whether he uses it or not. Number 13. Scooter renting and scooter taxi business. For a fixed battery scooter, the minimum time it needs to recharge is 1 hour. During this 1 hour, it is standing idle charging itself. If the shop is open for 16 hours, the scooter will be busy charging itself at least 6 to 8 times a day. If we imagine it is charged 6 times a day, it will be 6 hours of lost business. If 1 hour of scooter renting is Rs 100, he would have lost at least Rs 600 on a single scooter in a day. If he has 10 scooters, he will lose 6000 rupees in a single day. He will avoid such a loss if he uses extra battery to swap a discharged battery with a fully charged one. Electric scooters and theft. Although electric scooters come with a lot of theft protection features, they are not 100% foolproof. Electric scooters can be stolen by picking it up and carrying it away in a truck. Thieves can replace a motherboard or controller and it's as good as new. But the only reason the thieves might target an electric scooter is because of the battery. We all know the cost of the battery is almost half the cost of the scooter. Once the battery is removed from the scooter, it becomes useless for the thieves. Good thing about a removable battery is that whenever you park in places where you are not sure about the security of the scooter, you can always remove the battery and take it with you. This way, a scooter with removable battery is more secure than a fixed battery scooter. In the end, we can summarize that more people will buy removable battery scooters than fixed battery scooters. So those who want to keep making fixed battery scooters will only get a small market. EV companies love fixed batteries because people will become completely dependent on the company for everything, from repairs to fast charging, so they can exploit the customers. The biggest reason of all to having a removable battery, customer is king. A company has to cater to the needs of the customer and give him options and flexibility, irrespective whether he uses it or not. From all of this, it is very evident that removable battery has many advantages over fixed battery, while fixed battery has no advantages over removable battery. Please press the like button and share this video with your friends so that they do not fall in the trap of buying a fixed battery scooter. Thanks for watching. Talk to you soon in another video.